Hey there guys, it's your favorite backyard geographer again, out in the field. This time we're at Red Rock State Park, just a little bit north of Palmdale, Lancaster, just outside the Mojave, and we're gonna learn a little bit about some of the tectonic uplift, the layering, and what makes this place really, really beautiful. So what we stand facing here at Red Rock State Park is really some interesting geology. We're able to identify 18 distinct layers. That there's everything, mixtures of volcanics to breccias to even sandstones and conglomerates that have been brought in throughout really their very dynamic past in this location. We're also able to see that it's been uplifted or tilted towards us. We call this a hog's back because it's been tilted because of tectonics. So although we're not necessarily right on the San Andreas Fault, we're actually on part of what's called the Garlock Fault, which is an offshoot. It's perpendicular to the San Andreas Fault. So all of the area behind me has been tilted because of that offset. So speaking of geology, there's over 14 million years of local volcanics that have been deposited in this location. We also have an incredible fossil record that's been identified here. There's over 88 species of fossils found in this location, including rhinos, camels, and California state fossil, the Smilodon, the saber-toothed cat. Again, I mentioned that there's 18 distinct layers of volcanic debris. We actually are able to observe debris that's been deposited from places such as Yellowstone, which is several hundreds to even a thousand miles away from this location from when they had their massive eruption at Yellowstone National Park about 170 plus thousand years ago. The formation itself that we stand facing uplifted about 25,000 years ago. Again, I said it was part of the Garlock Fault system, which is a left lateral slip that kind of exposed all of this and makes it more observable for us today. Something else that I'd like to point out is on the standing face, we can actually see a fracture line. That's at an angle that drives all the way down, and that's also due to faulting. We can actually see that the layers are no longer continuous because part of the mountain range is being pulled down while the other side is going up. So we can see that there's a difference in that observation. We call that normal faulting. Normal faulting is when the rock itself kind of pulls away and drops down. Reverse faulting is the reverse, where it reverses itself up onto. So if this rock material was actually being pushed upward, we would consider that a reverse fault. But since this is normally falling away and faulting away, we call that a normal fault. Hey guys, real quick. So remember how I kept saying that there's a lot of different materials here, 18 different distinct layers? Some of it is sedimentary, meaning that that material was brought in. So an example of that that I have here is a piece of granite. Granite's not gonna be found necessarily in where we're standing. This would have been brought farther, more west of us, closer to the Sierra Nevada. Also in my hand here, I have a piece of basalt, which is probably more local to this area, judging on the volcanics that are here, but again, not in the exact spot in which we're standing in. So this is material that would have been moved in by running water. We call this alluvium. Okay. We all know that those were both igneous rocks, one intrusive and the other extrusive, but they're both sediments that were brought in by running water. So speaking of erosion, this is an excellent example of that. Like, where did this really large piece of rock come from? Well, it came from up there. It dropped down. But the advantage of it being at this level is that I'm able to observe the different layers. Again, that's stratigraphy in a sense, right? I'm able to see that we have these red compacted sandstone areas, and also looking at this lighter grayer area, I'm able to observe that this is really built up of larger, grain, coarser material. So I'm able to get a better, idea as to what is up there when it falls down here. Another thing that we can observe while we're here is, again, I mentioned how different layers are resistant to weathering, and we can see that this darker red area is significantly more resistant than the gray or white area, as you can see just by its erosion in its lateral plane. Some of the volcanics in this eastern Sierra region, we've been able to identify some of that material deposited as far south as Ventura County, which is pretty interesting. Age-wise, the most recent eruption in this area would have been less than 700 years ago, so obviously in human perspective, that was a long time ago, but geologically speaking, that was just like yesterday. So we still see a lot of that activity in this area when it comes to earthquakes, geothermal activity, springs, and things along that border. So again, here we stand facing one of my favorite stops along the Eastern Sierra. It's super easy to get to, heading up Highway 14, heading towards Mammoth. You see it, it's just, take that moment to stop by and check it out. I just love the contrast of the colors of the reds, the grays, and the brilliant blue sky that we have behind us. Don't forget to click like and subscribe. Comment below if you've perhaps been here or need directions. And hey, we'll talk soon.
Go.
So what is, all right, so I have this in my hand. It doesn't go there. So when, so I want to.
It's a million years.
You fall?
No, I'm good. Go.